Writing in the New York Times this week, author Jeffrey Toobin put out an op-ed with the headline simply titled, Donald Trump is going to get someone killed. And in this op-ed, Jeffrey Toobin, of course, points out the fact that Donald Trump is not only using incendiary rhetoric against all of the people who are investigating, prosecuting, or even presiding over his trials, but that's just half the story, right? Because Toobin points out something that I've actually pointed out multiple times just this week, and that is the mental state of the people who listen to Donald Trump and how they really only need just a minor push to do something horrific. Here's what Toobin has to say about that. Angry people, especially those predisposed towards violence, can be set off by encouragement that falls well short of the legal standard for criminal incitement. To see the consequences of such constitutionally protected provocation, one need only look to the case of Timothy McVey, who set off the bomb at the Alfred P. Murra Federal Building in Oklahoma City that killed 168 people on April 19, 1995. McVey, of course, had been following Newt Gingrich, you know, watching him in the news. He was listening to Rush Limbaugh. And their rhetoric about how evil the government is pushed McVey to commit this horrendous act. That's what we're dealing with Donald Trump. And the thing is, we don't have to look at, you know, examples from 30 years ago to actually see this in action. We saw it on January 6, 2021. You had a group of thousands of angry people who bought into the big lie about the 2020 election. Donald Trump gave them a little push. And that little push pushed them right on into the Capitol. Many of them at trial said, this is what Trump wanted us to do. Now, Trump never said storm the Capitol. He said, fight like hell, take your country back. But he never said storm the Capitol. But that's what they did, because that is how they interpreted it, and that is what they have told the judges overseeing these trials. They have literally said, Trump told us to do this. So when he goes out there, posts the home address of New York Attorney General Letitia James, calls her a racist, says that she is engaging in election interference, we've already seen what his base does when they think election interference exists. Toobin continues, Mr. Trump has never respected the norms of political behavior, and there's little reason to think gag orders will provide meaningful discipline either. As on January 6, his supporters shed traditional rules as well. The day is fast approaching when someone picks up a gun or builds a bomb and then seeks to follow through on Mr. Trump's words. If and when that happens, he will say that he did not specifically direct or cause the violence, and he will probably escape without criminal charges. But the blood will be on his hands. And that's the thing. Donald Trump knows how to use his language and his rhetoric in these situations. He knows he can't tell his supporters to go out there and do these things. So he plants the ideas in their head, right? He talks about these people on the other side as if they are some kind of cartoon villain that needs to be taken out. And he doesn't tell people to take him out, but they interpret it as such. We have already seen people be killed by violence from these MAGA cult members. And I think at this point, you know, Toobin says, if and when this happens, I don't think if is an option anymore. I think if Trump's language continues, we're not looking at if, we're looking at a matter of when. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week. So if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.